A child is this who lay to rest, a Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthem sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste, the bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold and myrrh, come peasant king to own him, the King of kings, salvation brings. Let love in hearts enthrone him. Raise, oh raise, oh Son on high, his mother sings a lullaby. Joy, oh joy, for Christ is born, the babe, the Son. Child is this who lay to rest, a Mary's lap is sleeping. Raise, raise a Son on high, his mother sings a lullaby. Joy, oh joy, for Christ is born, the babe, the Son of Mary. Joy, oh joy, for Christ is born, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Sun, do 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 do. Here comes the sun, and I say it's all right. Little darling, it's been a long, cold, long winter. Little darling, it feels like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun. And I say, it's all right.
Hello everybody and welcome. Giada Valenti here in the kitchen, in my own house. Yes, I know, I haven't been here for 2 weeks, so It's 2:07 here in Las Vegas to show you we are really live. And I know it's 5:07, must be 5:07 for you guys on the East Coast. Of course, it's late at night for you guys watching from Europe. It's either 22, so 10 p.m. In England and Scotland. I know many of you are always watching from there. Of course, in Europe, la mia mamma e mio papà and all of you watching from Europe, Italy, France, doesn't matter where you are in Europe, it's, of course, 11 p.m., almost time to go to sleep. Tempo di andare a dormire. Some of you may already be sleeping, like my mom and dad. And of course, it's good morning, buongiorno to all the friends that are watching from Australia. We had also last week some Canadian people, and I think Canadian people have more or less the same time of the East Coast or something like that, in the afternoon, late afternoon for you too. So welcome, welcome also for you. I see Antonio Argentieri, our pastry chef. I mentioned him because today I'm also making something sweet, which I normally never do. I always cook something salty. So Antonio, you're gonna be having a good time seeing how I made today something sweet. So circle of love, welcome to all of you. And of course, I see many of you there. And I wanna welcome also, we always do here at the Circle of Love, all the people that are watching for the first time. Welcome to you too. What time is where you're watching? Let us know where you are and what time it is, how you're doing, and welcome. I always say we do sign language here on Giada Live. Ever since we started this Giada Live, we started in March, we celebrated in September 150 episodes. We should be more than 200 episodes by now, I guess. I'm gonna count them and maybe we're gonna have a celebration one of these days. But ever since we started Giada Live in March, I was made aware about people, deaf people by Sal and Diane Fiorentino. They have a son who is deaf. And they told me that wearing masks was making it extra difficult for him to communicate with the world. So I decided to educate myself and all of you in sign language. And I want to thank many of you have been signing together with me and learned many, many signs. We know one very important is I love you, and we have become a circle of love. We are friends and family all together from all over the world, all over the world. So we are celebrating today in the kitchen. You know, Tuesday I have normally interview, Thursday we always go to Italy together with my dear friends of Italian Living and Richard Micheli. And on Saturday we are always in the kitchen cooking some delicious recipe, and today I will be cooking for you two little things that actually are kind of traditions for us in Italy, and I hope I decided to make, so maybe even if you are alone you can make it for yourself on Christmas Eve. So one is a famous tagliatelle with salmon and vodka. They are delicious. They are different variation. Now I make the one I normally make for you. And of course, I decide to make also a dessert that you can make also if you are by yourself. I'm going to tell you later. You can make a smaller version. And is of course, very Christmassy. Is il Pandoro di Natale, Pandoro Christmas tree. As you see, is we talked about it last Thursday. If you were with me on the Giada Live, we talked about il Pandoro, which is translated would be golden bread, and is a very famous sweet that we have originated in Verona. As you can see, it resembles a little bit the Alps, because Verona is not so far from the Alps, from the mountain in the winter. That's why they have the powdery sugar, the icing sugar that I have here. So a little bit of history, we also had it last Thursday, but just to remind you, so here is the story. They say that this kind of sweet golden bread was already existing at the Romans' time, because Pliny was already, Plinio in Italiano, he was already writing about this golden bread in the old ancient Romes that was made with white bread, honey, and some olive oil at the time. Of course, it became more popular around the Middle Age, in the 17th century, the Middle Ages, actually. Also in Venice, it was considered, remember, the poor people could not even have sugar. So only the rich could have onion and the sugar. They became very popular when the Venetians started to bring sugar from their travels around the world together with spices. And they were already creating this golden bread. So in the beginning, now it's for everybody. In the beginning, it was something considered only for the rich and the famous, the nobility. I nobili della di Venezia. As I told you, like Thursday, which I think is a fun details, they call it pan d'oro, which means golden bread. They were apparently so rich at the time that some of the decorations they were putting on the Pandoro at the time was really made of real gold. It was a kind of an eatable gold. The Venetians were sparkling not only with sugar, icing sugar, but also with icing gold, believe it or not. So today I decided to make, so you can eat, you can have it like this. You see it here, the Pandoro di Verona. We're gonna talk in a second because you originated in Verona, which is in the Veneto region. You can eat it like this, by the way, it's delicious. You just put, the, as I said, the icing sugar on top of it. It's made of bread and butter, so don't put it in the refrigerator. Put it in a warm environment, so when you cut it, you can feel the butter melting in your mouth. You can have it like that, or you can decorate it like we will do in a second, which you can make to look it even more like a Christmas tree. I do one kind of decorations, but you can decorate your Christmas tree like your own Christmas tree at home in many, many different ways. I'm gonna show you in a second how to do it. We go to Verona, by the way. Verona, I think it's one of the cities that we will be visiting next year in October. Yes, I'm still positive. The next year, October, we will be able to go to Italy together with the Perillo Tour. Do you remember? We talked about it. This October, unfortunately, was canceled due to COVID. But we hope to go next year to Italy with the Perillo Tours. And you can all join me. I always take with me every year a group of fans and friends. And I know many of you would like to join me. So we're going to have a lot of fun. And I think Verona, it's going to be one of the beautiful cities that we'll visit. JJ has some pictures he has to show you. Well, Verona, it's, of course, a beautiful, romantic, old city of the Veneto region. So it's not far from Venice. That's the famous Arena di Verona. I think, posted a picture from the sky. So here is, of course, Verona is famous for the balcony of Romeo and Juliet, La Storia di Romeo and Giulietta, and that's the famous balcony, and it's absolutely a beautiful place to visit. And of course, this is an aerial shot of Verona. It's as you can see, it looks like a big city, but one of the things I love about Verona, every time I go there, it's just like Venice. Everybody, every time, is stupefies how famous the place is and how small it is. Venice also is very small, and so it's Verona. So I'm looking forward next year to go together with all of you in Verona. So the Pandoro Melegatti, actually. So I remember, it was existing already by the Romans, and then in the 17th century, it was revived among the rich and famous. But the modern history of the Pandoro started in Verona in 1894, when Domenico Melegatti was a Veronese, you see him there, Domenico Melegatti, started a factory really, and he even had a logo, you see Melegatti, dal 1894, he started a factory. But by the way, that building still exists, the factory still exists. I found also some slideshow. This is Mr. Melegatti with a beautiful Pandoro that he created. Remember, it's made with eggs, sugar and butter and flour. And the factory still exists, of course. It's a much bigger factory, still family-owned in Verona. And I found also the picture how they were in the past. And the building here, the building that you saw, is not a factory anymore. Of course, the factory you see in a second is in a much bigger place. But it's still there and it's a touristic attraction. You see, in the building, I don't know if Mr. Melegatti himself did it, but somebody later, they even made some Pandoro cakes made in stone. And every time you go to Verona, of course, you see a lot of tourists looking up. And it's, Palazzo Melegatti is in Porta Borsari numero 21, number 21. Actually, every time we go there, we visit. And here you see the factory then in the beginning of 1900. And of course, now it's still a mass production, so they export it all over the world. There, of course, Melegatti was the first to invent, to brand this dessert, the Pandoro. But of course, here I have another famous brand. Thanks to Mary Lou and Bob, they found the Bauli, which is another traditional one. Of course, but there are many, many brands. Another very famous that I also hear is the Paluani. If you are in Italy, you can find, I don't know how many, maybe at least 10 very famous brand. Of course, Melegatti started, and then I think for 50 or 60 years, he was the only one able to produce them, and now they are mass produced. But always make sure when you buy a panettone, a Pandoro, that you read that it's made in Italy. And of course, if he said made in Verona, then you know you have the best. And if you can make it at home, there are some people, it takes a lot of work to make it at home. So I don't know anybody who made it. Probably Antonio, you can make the Pandoro at home. Even in my family, nobody made it at home. And if you are in Verona around the holiday, you will also find something that there are some story actually also saying that maybe the Pandoro that Mr. Melegatti branded started by, with a copy of another famous dessert around the holiday that they have only in Verona. It's called the Nadalin, which is in dialect, which would mean the small Christmas. Natale is the word for a Christmas, Natale. In dialect became Nadal, and Nadalin means a small Christmas. And here you see, as more or less this, a star-shaped dessert with low covered. He has also almonds, pine nuts, and according to the legend, I found this one, I didn't know, it was the result of an error of an unusual distracted pastry chef who would have put the Nadalin dough in a pudding mold and would have made it rise too much, and it became the first Nadalin, which actually is very similar to this one, but remember, he has also peanuts. This one doesn't have it. You know, I talk also about the sister of Il Pandoro, which is Il Panettone, the one with candies. I know many of you love that one. JJ actually really love the Panettone, which one has candies and dry fruits inside. And he also originated in the north of Italy, but not in the region of Veneto, but in the region of Lombardia. Lombardy, which is basically Milan. Now, of course, you find it all over the world, and you find it also here in the United States, because a few weeks ago, actually, we had it with Elena and Frank. I brought him to their house when we were doing the concert last week. And here is the Panettone, of course. This is JJ's favorite and many people's favorite because, of course, he has more taste. He has a lot of fruits, candies, and sugar. It's delicious. I love them both. But I must say, because I'm Venetian, Pandoro is my favorite. Without further ado today, so remember, you can have it like that. Let me put, first of all, let me put the water on, because my water needs to cook, because today we are we'll be cooking something. You remember I told you that Christmas night until Christmas Day we don't eat meat, we eat only fish in as a tradition. And normally il cenone di Natale, so is the dinner before Christmas Day, so the nights of the 24th. Many Italian America, in America, they have the seven fishes. We don't have that one in Italy. It's a tradition that Italian American brought here. But we have also all over the booth of Italy, we have something with fish. This is the sign for fish. And I decided to make something that we make often the Christmas night, which is tagliatelle with vodka and salmon. And I use tagliatelle, which is fresh pasta. And you see I have here the Cecco one. It's kind of dry, but it's made with eggs. But you can also make it with any kind of different pasta. And yes, there are different variations. I make today the one that I made the most. I try them all. This is one of my favorites. And of course, you can take off or add some of the ingredients. But so the water is cooking, and we're going to make this one in a second. But let me start by showing you the Christmas tree that I already made with my Pandoro. And I'm gonna show you how to come to this part of the Christmas tree. And then, of course, we start to decorate the Christmas tree. So I made a tree, and we will be decorating a Christmas tree all together. So here I show you how do you build your Christmas tree with Il Pandoro di Verona. Here we have a little video how to make this one. Very easy. It's very festive, as you can see. And it's easy. So you take a Pandoro cake, I hope you can find it, some Nutella and mascarpone. Nutella, of course, is chocolate, and mascarpone is cheese. So you pour the mascarpone in a glass bowl, of a bowl of your choice, and you add the Nutella. It smells fantastic. Make sure you find the Nutella. And don't use, you have other spread of chocolate, but that's my favorite. And you mix them together with a mixer, or you can do it also by hand if you want. I've done both. This morning I decided to do it with a mixer, and it will take you like a minute or two. You slice, and you start to slice your Pandoro, as you can see. You slice it in pieces like two fingers, I would say high. And you reverse them on a plate, just like you cut them, because later you're gonna be building your Christmas tree. So you cut your whole Pandoro and you start building your cake. So you take your spread of Nutella and mascarpone, very easy. And remember, you can put also Nutella by itself, or you can put mascarpone, and you can put some coffee on your pandoro. It's up to you. Important is that you place the pieces slightly shifted to create the point of your Christmas tree. You keep filling, continue building your tree until you're done. Remember, if you're only with the two of you, you can stop at that part and make a small Christmas tree. I decide today to make it the whole tall one, but you can make two small ones, so you make it less high. And then you build your Christmas tree. Yeah, I made it like for a big family. It's gonna be a lot of cakes, so I will be donating this one actually to Mary Lou and Bob, because they have a bigger family. So I make it for you guys, and then you can pick it up on Monday. And yeah, it's time to decorate. As you can see, it looks like a Christmas tree. At this point, so for the cream inside the filling, you can put Chantilly cream, you can put Nutella, you can put mascarpone and Nutella mixed together, you can put only Nutella, you can put even whipped cream, wherever you like. You can even put some coffee. If you use mascarpone, of course, you can put some bitter coffees, no sugared coffee, on you drop like your coffee on your mascarpone, on your pandoro, then you put your mascarpone and you get the thing. You're gonna get a kind of tiramisu pandoro. So it's sweet, so anything that is sweet you can put to fill the pandoro. Today I decided to use my mascarpone cheese and the Nutella. For the people that cannot hear, guys, this is a mascarpone, it's a cheese, it's a kind of cheese, and this is the Nutella. So, and then we can decorate it. So you can decorate it like a Christmas tree with whatever things you want. So today I decorate it like I would like to decorate it. So I took some whipped cream, and it's up to you. You can put a little bit of whipped cream on every point of your tree. Look at this. I'm gonna turn it around so you guys can see it. And remember, it's up to you how you wanted to decorate it. So this is gonna be for you, Bob and Mary Lou. So probably the cream will be all gone. You have to put it by yourself. Normally you have to decorate the Christmas tree of the last moment before your guest arrived, because as you understand, the whipping cream will be melting after a little bit. So you put it like this. It's gonna look so cute when it's done. So you put all your whipping cream everywhere. I cannot see. Normally in a normal world, you turn it like this and you do it while you see. And I was trying to do it in front of the TV. So can you guys see it? And you can put even Chantilly cream, any kind of cream of your choice. You can even make your own cream. If you are, for instance, if you are a pastry chef like Antonio, you can make your own one. So you get the point. So you try to fill all the point of your Christmas tree. Can you guys see it? I've forgotten one here. And remember, so at this point, like a Christmas tree, everybody can decorate it as they want. Any kind of sweet things you like. So I think I put it everywhere. So at this point, of course, you can put some on top of it if you want. Like this. Voila. You can even put a cookie if you want. And I decided to put some cherry that I got from you, Roger. You got me some cherry, but you can use strawberry, you can use any kind of fruits you wanna do, because this is gonna be actually your Christmas bowl. Look at that. You can put a different one. So let me start in the side I see, and then I turn it to you guys, because it's more safe. So you see it like it's gonna look like that. And you basically, at a certain point, you get the point. You decorate your whole Christmas tree. This is a nice job, by the way, to do for your kids. It turns down here and there, so remember. And it's kind of hot in my house, so it will melt. Normally, if you have guests, we won't have a guest this Christmas, because we're going to be by ourselves. You have to, I think I forgot one. You have to do this one when your guests are there, actually. And if you have kids, this is one of the most beautiful memories I have about decorating this little tree with my parents. My grandmother, my mama, they always let me do this one together with them. So you get the point. You put all this cherry everywhere. I didn't count them, so, but it looks like I have enough to decorate the whole Christmas tree. And remember, if you're only with the two of you, you just cut in half your pandoro and you decorate half of it for yourself. So you made a little, like almost like a nadaline, the one that I showed you before, so with less steps on your tree, and you have it for yourself. And the other one, you know when it's nice? The other one, in the morning with some cappuccino, you dip it in, and it's gonna be like the best breakfast you will ever have. That's what we have normally. So you get a point. And if you want, if you have one extra, I put it here. On top of here, many people also put like a little biscotto. You can put whatever you want. And I'm gonna pick it up for you, and I'm gonna show you how pretty it looks. And here is your Christmas tree. Voila. And if you want, of course, as I said, the cream is has to be a little bit cold. You can even put some sugar. This is the snow on the mountain, so you put some sugar in here, and voila. And remember, do this one when the guests are there. This is normally the powder that you put on top of your tree. And voila, it's snowing! I know it's snowing for you guys on the East Coast. I read a message before that you, Karen, are baking cookies. If I'm well informed, I will be baking cookies tomorrow too. With Alina, we are gonna make Christmas cookie, and Alina and Frank, as you may remember, is the beautiful house where we make the Christmas concert. And here's the Christmas tree. So at this, I'm not gonna cut it because, as I said, I wanna give this one to my friends. It's too big for a little family for me and JJ. But then you take the point. You cut it, and you can even cut it. I always say, cut a small piece like this, halfway, and take it out and serve it, and then the lower part, because otherwise you're gonna get a very big piece of your Christmas tree and it's impossible to eat. So I'm gonna put my Christmas tree actually here, so you guys can still see it's Christmas here in Valenti's house. And can you believe it, next week is gonna be Christmas, ladies and gentlemen. I see that my water is boiling. Of course, when the water is boiling, what do? We put inside some salt. So I put in some salt while my water is boiling. The tagliatelle that I'm using today, they cook in 5 minutes, so I'm gonna first show you, I'm gonna first put this one inside. So I'm gonna make, first of all, I show you again what I'm making. So after making the Christmas tree, I'm gonna make today the tagliatelle with salmone and vodka. I made it, you can make, actually the sauce will take you like maybe 10 minutes to make it, but I decided to make it earlier for me today because I only have one stove to cook, and I wanna cook in front of you. I don't wanna go over there. So I already made my sauce. So let me first put this one, the pasta, the tagliatelle, inside my water, which is boiling. I had some salt. Fresh tagliatelle, but remember, what happened? Here we go. I think two of those will do. Maybe a little bit more, and that's it. I didn't measure this one, so the pasta is cooking. I see 5 minutes there, and I show you how easy it is to make this delicious sauce. So JJ is gonna start the video how to make the sauce for this pasta that I said is good to make it on Christmas night because there is fish inside. And I have some vegetarian friends. I don't know, okay, can you guys have salmon? I don't know. Patricia, let me know. So here is how to make the sauce while my pasta, my tagliatelle are cooking. Tagliatelle with vodka and salmon. This is many different variations. This is how I made it this morning. Roughly chop the onions. I use half of it, as you can see. I make a portion for two. And then you put it in the food processor. Yes, it worked, Roger. You see, I got that one last week from Roger. It works perfectly. So you make it very small, your onions. And then in a saucepan, you melt the butter, a big chunk of butter. There's not olive oil in this one. And then you pureed your, you add your pureed onions. You add some tomatoes puree or pasta or paste, whatever you want to call them. 1 spoon is more for the color and the sweetness of the taste. And you stir for a few seconds to even the mix with the tomatoes. And you had some fresh parsley. You see, you remember, I buy fresh parsley and then I freeze it. So you can put it frozen in your pan, and then you slice your smoked salmon of your choice. This is my favorite from Trader Joe. I cut it in big chunky piece. I like the bite of it. And you put the salmon in your pan. from gentle to medium, so you you higher the fire a little bit. And that's the moment you had some vodka in the pan. And of course, it's gonna be evaporated, I've been told, so you cannot get drunk with that. But black pepper, on the, a lot of pepper, as you can see, I love the pepper, a lot of black pepper. Some lemon zest, I got the lemon from Elena, fresh one. And you're gonna stir until the vodka evaporated, 2-3 minutes. And at this moment, your sauce is almost ready. You put your crème fraîche, you know, I adore that crème fraîche. But you can use other kind of whipping cream or creams or heavy creams or your not sugary, of course. You simmer for a few minutes to reduce the sauce, and it's basically ready. So I show you mine here. I made it this morning. Since I made it this morning, it's gonna be dry out a little bit. So what do you do at a certain point before you put it on your pan? You're gonna add a little bit of water of your pasta, and you shimmer it together. And it's gonna get nice and fluid again. I'm gonna put it on top of my pasta in a second. Oh, my Christmas tree is it's too hot here. It's coming all down, like Christmas ball coming down from a tree. So guys, do you have special plans for Christmas? Of course, I'll be home for Christmas was the theme and the opening song of the concert last week, because we are gonna be home for Christmas, and we have to be home for Christmas. Europe is really in lockdown. Here in Las Vegas, we don't have a total lockdown, but kind of a lockdown. So we have to be careful. And is there a limit of people that can gather together, JJ, in Las Vegas too? Yes, how much is the limit? I think 10 people maximum, less. So no big family. So remember, you can make any one of my recipe for one, for two, even this Christmas cake. You see, it's like a Christmas coming down, like the snow melting now with the whipping cream. So the pasta is almost ready. I'm checking my clock. Remember, I decide to use, by the way, so let me say what we are making here. We are making pasta with vodka and salmon. And I don't know, did we show the card with the ingredients? Of course, not yet. So here are the ingredients. I forgot to show you the ingredients. Here they are. So you need the tagliatelle, of course. You need butter, onions, a tablespoon of tomato puree or paste, smoked salmon, 2 tablespoons of vodka, 5 tablespoons of creme fraiche. This is for two, by the way. Parsley, finely chopped, 1 lemon, and freshly ground black pepper, optional. But as you saw, that optional, it's a lot of pepper. There is no salt, because the salmon is a little bit salty already. And of course there is salt in, so I don't like to put much salt in my food. And actually I could, because I have very low blood pressure, but I know many of you have high blood pressure, so we have to stay aware from salt. So you can skip salt absolutely in this, in the sauce. Let me see, the pasta should be almost ready. And you know, that's always the best part for me, that, but I know you guys would love to be with me when it's time to eat my pasta and you are not here with me. So let me see. Yes, the tagliatelle are ready. So I'm gonna switch this off. Here we go. Here is my thing. I'm gonna put the water, and of course, you know the drill. Water out. This is always a dangerous moment because I'm not very handy. I'm very good in cooking, and now with JJ said, I'm very, always pretty close to disaster. I did a pretty good job today, JJ. Amazing enough. And thank you to my beautiful friends, my parents from another mother, Bob and Mary Lou. I got, you see, bigger pan and pots to cook my pasta. So here is my tagliatelle. I'm gonna put my sauce on it. Guys, I so wish you were here with me. I hope you're gonna make this pasta. It smells delicious. And remember, if you make the pasta, please take a picture and send it to me so we can all see it and I can share it with everybody. JJ, can they see? We should have like a camera coming down from the ceiling. Can we arrange that, JJ? That would be awesome. Very soon. So very soon we're gonna have like a lamp of a camera coming from the ceiling, so you guys can see inside. So now is the discussion. Are you going to put Parmesan cheese on this recipe? Yes or no? Yes, you can, because there is cream. Do you remember? If you go to Italy, they will not allow to put cheese on fish. And it's really a thing. In Venice, they will not do it. On this one, because there is already some cream, you can actually put some cheese. So I'm going to put some Parmesan cheese. It smells delicious, guys. I so wish you guys were here with me. And I'll show you in a second. And I will test them for you. I will sacrifice and test the pasta. And remember, this is always my lunch. I always cook on Saturday my lunch together with you. And I think I'm going to be making this pasta again on Christmas night, because it's a tradition. We normally do it on Christmas night. So let me take this one and clean my thing. You don't want to leave these delicious things on my thing. As I said, we can add on this one, we can add some Parmesan cheese, because there is cream. Normally on fish, you are not allowed to. Here we go. JJ, are you ready? So as you saw today, we skipped the cocktail. Diane was saying this morning, where is the cocktail? By the way, this is the sign for vodka, because we made it with vodka and salmon. But I said to Diane, there is no cocktail today because there is vodka in the pasta. So I'm going to give this one to JJ. By the way, I'll show you guys. Can you guys see? It looks delicious. And I'm going to taste mine and I'll let you know how it is. Let me see. So remember, this is something that you can make on Christmas night or even on Christmas Day. Even though on Christmas Day, we rather prefer in Italy to have something with meat. But I know I have some vegetarian people watching, so I'm wondering which kind of traditions do they have. It's delicate. It's delicious. I know. I made it so many times. It's one of my favorite. And remember, you can make it in different versions. There is also one with whiskey in place of vodka. There is also one, and in the one with whiskey, normally there's not tomatoes, tomato paste. So you can make that one. You can even actually add extra lemon should you want it. You can even squeeze some lemon on top of it. This is the one I like to make, and I make it most of the time, but you can even skip the vodka should you not add vodka. I know my mom makes it sometimes without the vodka. It still is delicious. It's just a different kind of taste. So guys, I'm going to leave you with my... I'm going to have dessert for the whole street. Actually, I'm going to give this one to Bob and Marilou. And I'm going to be seeing you probably on Tuesday for a quick hello. No interview until the new year. And in the meantime, if you miss me, you can always listen to my music. You can find my music on Apple Music, Spotify, Amazon. And you can also still download my single, What Child Is This? The one I recorded together with Paul Humbach and Vox. What Child Is This? I know many of you love it. And most important things, if you miss me, you can still, if you had already purchased your ticket of Love Under the Christmas Tree that we filmed exactly a week ago, we were not even ready a week ago. There are pictures. Look at the beautiful house of Elena and Frank, decorated to perfection with three amazing musicians, Dave Richardson, Paul Gada, and Pepe Jimenez. It was really a work of art. I'm so proud of it. So you can still watch the concert until the end of the year. And if you had not bought your ticket, you can still also buy your ticket and watch it on a replay on giadavalenti.com. You can find all information. And all the one of you that bought the VIP tickets, I recorded and filmed all my, you remember people that were buying a VIP ticket, they could have a special greeting and a special song sent privately for them. And I'm done with that one. So you cannot buy VIP tickets anymore, but you can watch on reply. So you go on giadavalenti.com and you can watch until the end of the year. And Frank, I think Frank was with us, right? I saw Frank, you bought two tickets for two family members of yours that were deaf. So please, I will contact you, because I'm going to give you another link for the Club's Capture version. And all of you that have friends that are deaf and would love to enjoy some Christmas special made with love, just wait until tomorrow morning and you're going to have a special link and you're going to have the closed captioned version. I saw it, it's beautiful. And I'm very, very grateful to Diane Fiorentino that she told me how to sign. There's also Diane signed a couple of songs. And I'm very, you see, we have there the sign of I love you. Look at this one, I'm going to take it for you. She gave me also this one. We all have now one. So this is the sign for I love you guys. And I really do love you. Thank you, Diane, for made me aware of this one and teach me American Sign Language. And I'm going to leave you. I'm going to have my pasta before it gets cold. And this is not a dish that is nice the day after. But I mean, if you have some leftover, you warm it up. My father loves it. I'm not so fan of the day after pasta. I normally never survive the day after. So guys, I love you. Thank you for being with me. I'm going to see you on Tuesday for a quick hello. And remember to watch the Christmas special should you want it. And you can still buy your tickets and let all your friends know at JadaValenti.com. So watch the replay of it. And we're going to see you next week. Actually, tomorrow, for the one of you that are already members of my Patreon, I forgot all about it. Tomorrow, I'm going to have my Patreon Love Song Sunday. So if you are a member of Patreon, I see you tomorrow at 2 p.m. for some music together. And you can still join. You can start join by $1. Guys, I'm going to eat and you are going to have a great Saturday. And ci vediamo domani. I'll see you tomorrow on Patreon or Tuesday here on the social media. Ciao. Bye. Love you.
Danke schön, dear old danke schön. Thank you for seeing me again. Though I'm here in my solitude, I know you are there, and in my heart I smile again. And so I sing here in my solitude, waiting to see you, same time, same place, and I can't wait to say again, Dankeschön, Dankeschön, Dankeschön.